Music and Booze with Mo is produced and distributed by EatsDrinksTV, a service of the Center for Culinary Culture, home of the Cocktail Collection, and First Reel Entertainment, and is available wherever fine podcasts can be heard. The Center for Culinary Culture, telling the story of food and drink, one taste at a time. Welcome to Music and Booze with Mo. I'm Mo Herms, and I've worked in the music industry most of my life, so have met some pretty amazing musicians over the years. I also love a good cocktail, and I've encountered some really interesting bartenders as well. It seems that there is a lot of crossover, so when I can, I like to talk to musicians and bartenders about music and booze. Join us at the bar, won't you? Music and Booze with Mo is brought to you by The Mermaid, a cozy neighborhood bar with an aquatic flair in the Little Tokyo area of downtown LA. Open 7 days a week, featuring tropical cocktails and snacks, The Mermaid also has a daily happy hour from 5 to 8 p.m. Follow The Mermaid on Instagram at TheMermaidLA to hear about upcoming events and check them out at TheMermaidLA.com. Head to 428 East 2nd Street, Los Angeles, for a drink. Summer is upon us, and you know what that means, lots of tropical cocktails. So I will focus for the next couple of months, like I did last summer, on bartenders who specialize in these kinds of drinks, tropical, tiki, etc. What's the etc.? Well, we'll find out over the course of the next couple of months. It's Mo's tropical summer, so get ready for an exotic getaway of the cocktail variety via the Music and Booze with Mo podcast. On this episode, we are going to Waikiki, not Hawaii. It's actually a bar called Waikiki in Mexico City. We're going to speak with Luigi Hernandez, who is the bar manager of Waikiki and has been into tiki for over a decade, and he's only 25. He was always obsessed with the Beach Bum Berry books once he started learning about them, and also learning about the similarities between the look of tiki and style of tiki and community and what he's grown up with in Mexico, the rich cultural heritage that is Mexico, and kind of intermingling the two. It's very interesting. Also, what do you do when you're making these classic tiki cocktails and you can't get what is prescribed to you in the recipes? You make do with what you got. So he's come up with some really inventive cocktails as well. We're going to talk about that and lots more, like the ukulele, coming up now.
Prints and the pictures, you know, and the masses of from Oaxaca and the Danza de los Diablos. It's his other.
That's so great.
Yeah, right now it's closed. It's open. The bar is at the 5 p.m.
Oh, it's beautiful.
Yeah,
it's
right really now it's beautiful. Making preproductions and making a cocktail, you know?
There's a lot to do. You know, that's beautiful. Oh, thank you for showing me that. Oh, I'm so excited to get to visit one day. How was the event?
Yeah, you know,
you guys had Nova and the Vato Sutiki were with you guys this weekend, right?
Yeah, I want to write this is the Tiki as on the family, you know, they're from the Okay. And the culture tiki for me is wonderful. No, it's just when a world in the this is that when think about it, the tiki is crazy, you know, because it's a culture and drinks and family, you know. It's crazy, you know. The tiki and culture is the different parts, no? I'm Polynesian, and Tahitian, and Maori, and Hawaiians, and whatever, no? In Mexico, there are no existing culture tiki right now. It's very difficult, no? I am working on the 6 years ago, and they follow the culture tiki, no? Mm-hmm. I'm learning in the culture tiki in drinks, and the beach bumberry. The beach bumberry are really here in the size in 2015. Mm-hmm. Yeah, it's my teacher. It's wow. Yeah. I go in the New Orleans, I go in the on the lake and San Francisco, another different part of California when it's the celebrity and the culture tiki and in the world, no? It's the revival tiki in California, no? It's beautiful. In Mexico, we have different cultures, no? Zapotecas, Mixtecas, Toltecas. It's too much on the cultures Mexicans because this is a year old. I am working in the book and the pre-Hispanic or pre-Hispanic tiki, no?
Wait, you are working on that?
Yeah.
Oh, wow.
I am working on the book, no? It's a pure culture tiki. I want mix and the culture Mexican, no? Mm-hmm. I understand the culture tiki on Mexican is one influencers, no? The Batos tiki, you know? Batos mm-hmm. tiki is, mm-hmm. is one of culture Mexican, no? They have a living in LA, no? Tiki Diablo is one of part Mexican, no? Mm-hmm. Other parts, different Mexicans mm-hmm. live in the culture tiki, you know?
mm-hmm. So you brought up something already that I wanted to talk to you about. But before we go any further, I want you to introduce yourself. I'll introduce at the beginning. And then tell me, I know, but for the listeners, what your job is. You have a lot of... You're not just doing the bar. You also have your company with the mugs and stuff too.
Yeah.
So tell everyone your name first.
Okay. My brand or my me?
I know. Your name first.
Okay. Tu nombre. Okay. My name is Luigi Hernandez. I have 25 years old. I live in Mexico Street. I am working in Waikiki Tiki Room as I am a head bartender. Mm-hmm. I am working on consulture and the brands and different the rums. I'm working on the Real, Tandway, Bacardi, different companies, no? Mm-hmm. I am working on the CEO from the door, other different partners, and the Tiquilja. Tiquilja is one of its new brand and the culture mm-hmm. tiki books in Mexicans, no? Mm-hmm. Tiquilja is the first man also. It's two different languages. It's one of mixed language, no?
Okay.
It's Maori and Maya. A culture Maya Mexican. Tiquilja.
Oh, that's cool. Yeah. So this is what I was really intrigued by because you are a tiki bartender. You work in, is this the only tiki bar in Mexico City?
Yes. Yeah. This is unique, the bar in Mexico City. Tiki, no? Because, there on the bars, very similar and tiki culture mm-hmm. bars because mm-hmm. it's not this. When you arrive at the tiki bars, it's different, no? It's mm-hmm. It's decor and good drinks, good hospitality, mm-hmm. good a lot of time drinks and step in the bar, no? And Waikiki is the same, no? And other different bars is when you arrive at, let me one drink a Mai Tai or Zombie or Chiflapulapu. They are not as a pure beer.
Fuck.
No.
So but you're doing something where you're taking what in the United States we see tiki as, like you were saying, purely Polynesian, right? But there are people in the tiki scene in the United States who are Mexican and or of other cultures and are bringing that into it. And this is what it's tiquilja, right?
Yeah, tiquilja.
Uh-huh. Tiquilja. So tiquilja, that's what you're doing, right? Aren't you taking, you're taking like Mexican, ancient Mexican images.
Yes.
and turning that into mugs. You're turning those into, so it's your own culture and you're doing it in the style of what is seen as tiki culture. Yes.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. I know. Yeah. It's my brand is a culture Mexican. It's when I mix on the Polynesian, no? Because we have a different mugs. Mm-hmm. Let me 1 second.
Sure.
Bro, préstame unos tiquis míos, no? y el zombie.
We get to see one.
Okay, mira, you can see. This is el luchador. Mm-hmm. This is my brand. Mm-hmm. No, it's the first spirit and the lucha libre in Mexico. You know, mm-hmm. I love it. The cats. Mm-hmm. This is the one a cat.
Yay!
It's a pretty drink here. Became, yeah.
And these are the mugs you're making.
Yeah, is this a zombie Maya?
Oh, that's beautiful. Very beautiful.
Zombie Maya. Yeah.
So just for anyone people will be listening, so I can describe this. It's a yellow mug, but it is a Mayan zombie.
Yeah, Mayan zombie.
Instead of what we're used to seeing in these sort of Polynesian ways.
Yeah, it's one of mix, no? It's one of mix of the cultures and Mayan and Mexicans and Polynesians is within us when creation and the brand is wonderful because it's out. In Mexico, there are no exist on the tiki mugs, no? Mm-hmm. Or this is very expensive. Yeah, I think it's one years ago. Mm-hmm. I need one brand. It's the name Mexican, no? Mm-hmm. Tiki mugs is very cheap, no? Okay, in the United States, it's more expensive when you buy one tiki mug, no? Mm-hmm. $200.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, $200, $300. In Mexico, when you arrive at one, two tiki mug and $200, nah, it's too much. It's too much.
I think a lot of people in the United States think it's too much also.
Yeah, in tiki oasis, last week and 3 weeks ago, 2 weeks ago, it's one tiki mug, the moon tiki and false idol. Mm-hmm. Right now, it's at the sale, $650.
Whoa! Oh, wow. So you're offering something that is much more local. So it's cheaper, but it also reflects your community and your culture within this tiki world, within the tiki trappings. Are your drinks like that as well? You were saying that you are working with rums. And I don't know how prevalent rums are in Mexico because my experience in Mexico, I was always looking for tequilas, right?
Yeah, I know.
And I know there is it Paranubes? Is that the...
Yeah. In Mexico, okay, this is what I want to question because in Paranubes, and 2 years ago, this exists in Mexico. Okay, this is one of the products that we make in Mexico, Oaxaca, because they are not sell in Mexico.
Oh, really?
Yes, it's pure importation.
So what do you guys get for yourself then? You can get all the Havana Club, I know, because we would go to Mexico and buy that. So you get the actual Cuban Havana Club.
Yeah, I know. in Mexico, when you make a cocktail stickies, you know, and you use this and Jamaican rums and obstacles, Barbados rums and
all of it's
there. Rums, no, and other different and Puerto Rican rums and other different brands. No, in Mexico, there are no exist on Jamaican rums. This is the unique rum in Mexico. There exists. This is one Appleton Estate.
That's the only one.
Really? Yeah, it's really no. There are no Hamilton. There are not Coruba. There are not Majors. There are not not something. There are no exist on the 151 in Mexico.
Mm-hmm. So then that must be a challenge for you to make some of the recipes that you found in Beach Bum Barry's books because he calls for so many different kinds of rum.
Yeah.
So how do you get around that? How have you made the drinks so that you love them? What are you substituting with?
Oh. One for me, I wouldn't drink it, so no.
Yeah.
Oh, the books of Beach Bum Barry, or it's like preferring to make it.
Yeah, because I would think it would be difficult to make them the way he has them, since you can't get a Jamaican rum except for one.
Yeah.
Or you can't get.
When I make a cocktail, say, I prefer to exchange some different rums. No, Mexican, no, there are no exist rums goods. I prefer and use the Cuban rums, Mexican rums, mm-hmm. other different rums. This is when I blend in, no? I make kind of the blends different rums for the tasting and the mouth.
You're making your own blends.
Yeah, mm-hmm. I know. Because it's one example, no? Zombie 1934, no? The recent classic, the Don de Vizcumber is Ron de Merada, Ron Jamaicano, Ron Puerto Rican, 151, Herbert Saint, Don Mix, Grenadine, Lime Juice, Falernum, it's okay. In Mexico, there are no, this is the rum. It's, and my bar is a Bacardi 8 years old. Santa mm-hmm. Teresa is one of rums. Venezuela. Flor de Caña, 12 years old.
Okay.
Yeah, 151 Plantation. This is the unique arrived here. Mm-hmm. This is in Mexico. The life is different, no? Mm-hmm. You have elements, you have different ingredients. This is ingredients mm-hmm. because you have one cocktail. It's very similar on the recipes, the Beach from Berry, or the recipes, the Travis Biggs, or recipes, the Martin Kate, or recipes, the Travis Biggs. It's very, very different because in Mexico, you uses ingredients Mexicans. No, more. No complete your life.
Wow, that's quite a challenge that I wouldn't have thought about. We are very lucky in the States to have so much access to so many different rums, but I think you are so obsessed with the flavors and the taste that of course you're going to create a blend that's going to be delicious.
Yeah,
you know, it's going to work. So what? How have you, since you're creating a Mexican tiki bar, basically? How are you? What other ways are there? Ways when you make a drink that you're making it more Mexican? You know, because you have all these drinks that come from the United States, right?
Yeah.
You know, and some of them come from Cuba and some of them come from Jamaica, but a lot of them originated in the United States.
And for example, now in Waikiki Tiki Room, I'm working on different the menus for the template. No, this is one example. No, Tiki in Spring is the is the menu spirit and the celebrity and the Don de Vizcumber Beer Day and the 114, no? It's a cocktail spirit and the cocktail is very popular and the style of Don de Vizcumber, no? And Pearl Diver, Bulldo, Don Beach, example, mm-hmm. no? It's my team and me, as I'm working on the new menu, is the spirit and the ingredients Mexicans, no? One cocktail con tequila, one cocktail con mezcal, three mm-hmm. cocktails con rum, and different, no? Mm-hmm. Right now, I am working on, and the new menu is a patrio tiki, no? Patrio tiki is a culture Mexican.
Okay.
Yeah, it's culture Mexican, with cocktails, experience, and the candies Mexicans, and the food Mexican, mm-hmm. and 15 and 16 September is Independence Day here in uh-huh. Mexico. This is when I party, you know?
Yeah. When I party Mexican. So you have to have that menu ready for September.
Yeah. It's in my cocktails, it's a spirit in the culture of Mexicans, no? And the example, and 1 year ago, I am working on the one, El ahogado is when a cocktail is pureing, and the chile en nogada is when a dish food, no, is from Puebla. It's when a chili with a pomegranate, one a cream, and cheese, and nucumec, and
oh, so this
cherry.
Is food. Is a,
yeah, okay. Okay. It's when I okay.
It. It, I think you said it's like a poblano with pomegranate.
Yeah, chile poblano. Yeah, mm-hmm. I know. It's what my recipe is for experience. This is the fruit. No, it's standard.
So you're taking this and turning it into a drink.
Yeah. I'm making on it. It's very similar. Cool. No, I make on the orgeat, and nutmeg, and cold cheese, brandy, and sherry, one mix on the lime juice and chili tatemado, mm-hmm. chile grill.
Wow.
Yeah.
That sounds incredible.
Yeah, it's stress.
When did you start bartending?
Oh,
yeah. When did you start?
Oh,
because you're young.
Yes. I have to. Oh, it's 15.
You're 15 years old.
Yeah. Yes. I am a student on the gastronomy and
really?
Drinks. Yeah. I am working as student. Starting working as student. No. And when you finish, I am a student on the bar manager and the. Like the IBA, Association International Bartenders, no, in the world. I am working in competitions and brands and different, mm-hmm. no. My passion is on the and the cultures in the bars is always part of my life, no. It's, and before my mother, he working in the bars. My Austin, my cousins, I working in the bars. It's always my how about 10, 8 years old is. Mm-hmm. My cousin is talking about this is when I drinks. Oh, hey, Luigi, I in my bar I work, I make a cocktail, pina colada. It's like, oh, I always.
So your always, whole family has worked
yeah,
in bars.
Yeah, 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 yeah.
So, and so you've been working in bars since you were 15 years old. And
yeah.
when did you start running the bar? Because you now make your own cocktails. You are managing everyone else and you're in charge. When did that happen?
Oh, well, it's very difficult because, when I come in this chart, the bartender in my career culture is, I am working on different the works, no? Brand ambassador and bartender.
So you were doing all of those things.
Yeah, it's on the different steps. No, always it's on the bar manager.
Okay.
No? You're working on the process and the down up. No, it's
good though to learn all the other parts.
Yeah.
Now you understand all the different pieces. You know what the brand manager. Or what the brand representative wants from you, you know? you know how to run the restaurant. You know how to do all those things. So when Waikiki opened, are you part owner here or you're just part of the team?
I am working on the bar. Yeah.
So how did you come together with them? Because it sounds like your passion for Tiki happened when you
6 years,
discovered the books.
Six years ago.
And that's when, is that when Waikiki
opened? Yes, for
opened?
Me. No,
for you.
Opened the Waikiki and 2 years ago.
Okay.
2 years ago.
So
I'm working 2 years ago.
How did they find you? Because
you
are the perfect person to be working there. Were you working at other bars and doing tiki drinks?
Yeah, I am working on difference. Is one example. No, in my life, I am working on, cocktails, bars, speakeasies, I know. I am working always on my life is sticky, no? I am working and behind the bar on construction, the cocktail classic, contemporary, and other different,
well, and
no?
You said you were competing as well.
Yeah. This is the bar Tiki, when, this is for me for one surprise, no? Because 2 years ago, I am living in Playa del Carmen, Tulum, mm-hmm. Caribbean Mexicans.
And you're living there.
Yeah, I am living there. I'm working on the bar manager of one hotel. The name Azulik is the five stars. Yes, it's crazy. It's quite crazy. My friends, I am working in the bar manager in the group, no? Mm-hmm. And Waikiki is one of the group. Hanky Panky is one of speakeasy bar in the 50 years in the 50 best bar and Brujas and Waikiki and Huset and Pigeon. Oh, it's a five different the styles and the cultures
got
drinks,
it.
No? Okay.
It
bar manager, location manager is one day, so they called me, it's Luigi, hello, bro. You want to bag a Mexico City? I have one work for you, no? Oh, really? I am working. You want to work for Waikiki Room? Oh, of course. Yeah, of course you do.
It's your dream.
The moment is when I arrived here is different, no? Because and culture drinks is you need all the learnings. It's a more time. It's the leaf and the culture tiki all days, no? Because it's you no understands. No, as Mexican no understand culture tiki. Yeah, it's very difficult. Yeah. When you make a cocktail, it's a tiki cocktails. Mm-hmm. The people see a drink is Hawaii. No, Hawaii. In Hawaii, no exist a culture tiki drinks.
It's true.
No, this is vacation. No, not drinks. You know.
So you're teaching people about tiki as well. Or about what the tiki cocktail culture is all about. Yeah. So you're teaching them. And how have the people of Mexico City responded? Do they like it?
Yeah, I like it. No, it's when you come in or when you arrive at the bar, it's the first time in my bar, I introduce you, and the culture tricky drinks and the culture tiki, no, the only cucumber, the Polynesia, con tiki, and difference, no, it's very similar, no, it's one example, and Jeff Rich Bumberry, no, he's telling me, Luigi, it's the best moment, the tiki, is when the world is a fail, no? It's okay. Yeah. No, I like, okay. It's culture, no? In Mexico, in two years more, I think it's a new bar tiki, no? Mm-hmm. It's too much people is interested on the culture tiki, no? Mm-hmm. Drinks popular, no? Mm-hmm. Culture fresh.
So they're learning more about it, and you think that there will be more tiki in Mexico City.
Mexico City is tacos, culture tacos.
Is that what he's saying back there? Well, see, I think it's really great you're showing an appreciation for the culture that tiki came from. And that's a discussion in the States that people are having. That there's a concern that people don't appreciate the culture it actually came from in the United States. Some people do, and some people just like to wear Hawaiian shirts and are not as respectful. And I think because you're living in a country that has an old culture, an old historical culture, and you guys already respect your own culture. So I think that's why it's easier for you guys to respect someone else's culture as well. It's Americans. we don't have a very old history, so we don't have that to learn from and everything.
What is the best bar tiki in the United States for you?
For me,
what is the three? Yeah, three tops.
Oh, my top three. You're not supposed to interview me, Luigi. That's a tough call. I think I do like the old spots, the Mai Kai in Florida. Did you ever get
good.
To go?
Yeah.
Oh,
yeah,
it's so beautiful. I hope that it opens again. That's such a beautiful historical place. Latitude 29, Jeff Beachbum Berry's place in New Orleans. That place
is
incredible.
Scars.
I love it very, very much. And if I have to pick one more, someone's going to get mad at me. It's a tie between the Trader Vic's in Oakland.
Okay.
And Tiki T in Los Angeles.
Ooh.
And the reason for me, for both of those, is I lived in Oakland for a long time. And I used to go to Trader Vic's all the time. That was probably the first tiki bar I ever went to, just because I was 18 when I moved to that part of town. And so I have a lot of love for that place. Plus, it's beautiful. And it's always been really fun for me. And Tiki T is similar in that it's old. It's always been there. I lived in that neighborhood. Both those places were my neighborhood bars long before I was involved in the tiki world. So or that I knew so much about it and met all these people in it. So probably, you know, those two, I can't decide between the two because they both have a lot of sentimental meaning. They're very emotional for me, both of those places. So I guess that's four, but that was close. What about you? What is your favorite? You've actually been able to travel to the United States.
Oh, very good question. Oh, I like it more. It's the Mai Tai. Yeah.
Oh, the Mai Tai.
Latitude. Mm-hmm, yeah, mm-hmm. Of course. The other is I love it bar. Lost Lake.
Lost Lake. Oh, you know, I've never been to Lost Lake.
No, Lost Lake is beautiful.
Now they're calling themselves a tropical bar now. They don't refer to themselves as a tropical bar anymore because of the issues people are having with the terminology. The
tiki tea, I love a tiki tea because it's explosive. No, it's explosive in the mall. Mm-hmm. It's crazy. It's crazy.
I think tiki tea, of all those places we talked about, tiki tea is the one that feels the most like a community.
Yeah.
Mai Tai does as well. Mai Tai definitely has fans, but the tiki tea is so small and it's still family owned and operated. And when you go there, everybody knows each other and they're not necessarily people who are tiki people. They're just people who live in the neighborhood. So it does have that community, which I think you love very much, as do I. That's one of the things that makes bars so wonderful is the community that you can build around, you know?
Yeah. And I know.
Yeah, that's what you love. You love bringing people in and making them drink, teaching them about all this stuff. So that's incredible. I love it. So, okay, I have to talk to you now about music.
Oh, okay. Well, my music preference is when I stay in my house, I can take music on the ukulele, you know?
Do you play the ukulele?
Yeah.
You do? When did you start to play the ukulele?
This is 1 year ago. It's on the free pandemic. It's mm-hmm. It's a free learning for the friend on Curso. It's on the free. It's very easy because I'm before working on the bars. It's music, you know. I am taking on the piano and take lots. Mm-hmm. Yes.
How many musical instruments do you play?
Two.
Piano and ukulele?
Yeah.
When did you start to play piano?
Oh, when 10 years. Yeah. It's very young. Yeah, it's okay. It's very difficult because this is, you understand the culture of music it's difficult because it's how you were when you're ready of the one scripture now it's mm-hmm. off. It's mm-hmm. on the words and the music it's different now. A C B D da da da. No. Okay, I am staying in my house. I prefer the music the Elvis Presley music and the Don Tiki and
so like the 50s and...
I like it music on the exotica music, no exotic mm-hmm. music. The Don Tiki, Elvis Presley. I like it more rockabilly.
Uh-huh. Train, train, coming down the line. Train, train, coming down the line. Well, it's bringing my baby, 'cause she's my all.
Rockabilly, this is not picky, no. Rockabilly is after, no. Mm-hmm. Because it's good, it's good. I am preferring more when I'm working or when I'm staying with my friends. Oh, it's some rap. I love it, the rap. Mm-hmm. Rap Mexican, rap United States. Now Snoop Dogg, no Tears Big, Tupac, new crowd, whatever. Well, no, so
I got that'll always get you energized if you're listening to rap. It definitely like, you're like ready to go.
Yeah. Eminem, no, Dr. Dre. Yeah, this is on the culture, hip hop, rap of the 90s, no? Yeah.
Rap of the 90s, is that what you said? What is, if you are getting ready to open the bar, no one is there, and you're listening to rap, what is the rap that you're listening to that's making you excited and ready to open the bar? You know,
it's one example, no? In Waikiki, to have a different playlist. Mm-hmm. Also when a Waikiki date, no, it's the music, Hawaiian music, no, mm-hmm. it's the pure relax, no, it's when 7, 8 p.m. is mm-hmm. the change of music and hip hop and rap.
Really?
Or the reggae. Yeah, and the reggae. Yeah. Because in Mexico, you put music, rockabilly or music classic tiki, is the people are drinking two more drinks. The people they need I need a sleep. No, you know? Yeah.
And you have to keep everyone energized, right?
Yeah, you have to energize.
But for you, okay, let's go back to you at home. So you're at home, and what makes you energized? What's the music? It's the rockabilly. Tell me a couple of your favorite. What are your favorite rockabilly songs? Tell me one or two of your favorite rockabilly songs.
Kula, I like it.
Kula.
It's Mexican. It's when I'm Mexican.
Is that the artist or the song? I've never heard of that.
Yeah. The Rebel Cats and the Cats in the One.
You're going to have to email me some of these because I want to look them up. I work in music and I want to find them so I can listen to them. I'm not that familiar with Mexican rockabilly. I should be. I'm sure it is. I mean, Mexicans do rock and roll really well. They do heavy metal really well. So of course you should do rockabilly really well as well. Also, so you'll have to send me those names because I want to hear it.
Yeah.
The name of the artist that you like, you know, so you like this kind of, have you always liked music from the past? Like you always liked 50s and 60s?
Yeah.
That kind of music, even when you were young?
Yeah. Oh, wow.
Because, I mean, if you like tiki is kind of an old fashioned style of cocktail, you know? Yeah, and so it's the fact that you like that and you like that culture that's come from it. You like the history and the cultural appreciation, but you also like old rock and roll music too. And I like that. I like that you like all that old stuff. It's very complete. So in the bar though, you guys do listen to some exotica during the day for people?
Yeah.
Then at night, it's just a party.
Yeah, I didn't reach it to prioritize now.
I love it. That's awesome. Well, I wasn't sure if there was anything you wanted to talk about. We could probably wrap it up. We know Waikiki is in Mexico City. So if anyone listening ever wants to have a fantastic tiki cocktail while they're in Mexico City, Waikiki is the place to go.
Let me go.
Yeah, right? And then if someone is interested in checking out your mugs, the ceramics.
Yeah.
Tequila?
Tequila.
Tequila. It's making me think of...
It's very similar to one tequila. Tequila.
I was going to say, it sounds like tequila, the drink.
Tequila.
Tequila. Okay, I'm going to put that in the notes so that people can find it. And they can see your very special mugs because I looked at them and I you mentioned Tiki Diablo, who is a sculptor here in the States, but Tiki Diablo, Danny.
Tiki Diablo is el boss.
Yeah. Oh, he's so good. He's so creative. He's made some very beautiful interiors for bars all over the world.
And
beautiful ceramics. And I think he has taken a stand a couple years ago to not use Polynesian idols anymore. And to use things that come from his background. So he has like some Day of the Dead style, you know, mugs and things like that, that are really beautiful. And it looks like you're doing that as well. With
My artist favorite, this is the Tiki Diablo, Bamboo Club, Bamboo Band. Bamboo Band is good. Ebba Kum is good.
Yeah.
Or, All Island is good. It's my friend.
He's good. I like he's it. Really
yeah,
good too.
Yeah, Daniel is good. Yeah.
Outline is wonderful.
The work you're working is wonderful. No, it's a human and making and the difference, the mooks and the difference, the process. This is very it's cool. It's all vintage, you know. because it's good. I like it. And tiki-toni is good because this is my thing is the feeling is, oh, it's too much on colors, it's too much on other, you know. Yeah, because I like it more, mm-hmm. because I am preferring on the vintage and the tiki diablo. Oh, the Bokum, no, Bokum is crazy, no? It's
really, yeah, oh, good work too.
The tiki mok, the Bokum, he made, no?
Yeah. So, okay. Good. So tell people how they can find you on Instagram. You have an Instagram, right?
Yeah. Okay. My Instagram is Don Tiki Loco. Don Tiki Loco. Yeah. My brand is Tikilja Mux.
I know. I'm going to try to look it up right now because.
You're feeling it right now.
Because, you know, my mom, she was the Latina.
Yeah.
There it is. And she was from Colombia. And she used to always say, she could not say the word sheet, like you need to change the sheet on the bed, because it sounded like she was saying a bad word in English. So when we were little kids, she wouldn't say that. So I understand your accent. So you're the, you're Don Tiki Loco on Instagram, and your company is Tequila. It's Tequila.
¿Tienes una pluma ahí? No.
Oh, I looked it up. Tikilja. There it is. Tequila.
Yeah.
So people can look that up too, and then they can see all of the mugs. They're really beautiful mugs.
Yeah.
I would need to order some of them. You guys have these, like, are they fish? They look like
no,
sharks.
They're not a fish. I how about one shark?
They're sharks. I was going to say, look, are they sharks? That's good. Okay, cool. So hopefully people will find that there. And I just want to say thank you so much.
Thank you. Today. Forget the telly. We just go to the crib and watch a movie in the jacuzzi. Smoke L's while you do me. I love it when you call me Big Papa. Throw your hands in the air if you's a true player. To the honeys getting money, playing niggas like dummies.
Muchos gracias to Luigi for being my guest. It was so fun to talk to him, and I cannot wait, really cannot wait, to go to Mexico City and visit him and Waikiki and everything that he's doing there. So, if you want to find him on Instagram, it's Luigi, L-U-I-G-I, _ Rick, R-I-C-K, Ricky Tiki. So, or Tiki, sorry, Luigi _ Ricky Tiki. And then his mug company that he was talking about is at Tequila, which is Tikilja. So go check those things out. Of course, you want to zip over to my Spotify page over at Shibimo on Spotify, same as on Facebook. And I'll have a link to his playlist because he threw some really fun songs out for us to listen to. So go check all of that out. And thanks again so much to Luigi. He is just such a bright spot. Big smile, ray of sunshine kind of person, as if you couldn't tell from that interview. Just the energy is overpowering. How can you not be happy right now? Thank you, Luigi. Music and Booze with Mo is brought to you by Barkeeper, a head shop for cocktail lovers, located at 614 North Hoover Street in Silver Lake, Los Angeles. Stop by for barware, vintage glassware, a carefully curated collection of spirits, and one of the most impressive selections of bitters anywhere. Follow them on Instagram and Facebook for information regarding spirits tastings. That's barkeepersilverlake.com, and also in the Virgil Village neighborhood of Silver Lake, Los Angeles. Thank you for tuning in to our barroom chats on Music and Booze with Mo. For more info about today's guest, or if you want to connect with me, check out my Facebook page, Mo Herms. Please subscribe to the podcast and feel free to tell all your friends about it. While you're there, give the show a rating and a review. It really helps to get the word out. If you want to hear the playlists our guests have curated, search She Be Mo on Spotify. S-H-E-B-M-O. Find pictures of the interviewees and the cool stuff they create on the Music and Booze with Mo Instagram account. Lower your expectations and join us at the bar. Till next time, cheers.